How many of you are here because you're going to have a lot of fun?
Yeah! Great!
Super! So we're all set?
Yes.
Yes? So sit down, because coming your way is a fun guy. His name is Ali, but we want to know how Ali became Bajrang Bali.
One morning in Vaigachol, it was not a long morning. Unni, the owl, was staring at something in the distance. Widuri, it was morning. And Unni, the night owl's eyes were open. Rakshas, he said to Bali. Everyone in the tree began to talk at once nervously. Unni said, लोहे के राक्षस इंसान हमला करने वाले हैं हम पर, वो हमारे घर को तहस नहस कर डालेंगे, बड़े बड़े लोहे के दांत हमारे पेड़ को काट डालेंगे। वो केकड़ा राक्षस अपने बड़े बड़े जबड़ों से धरती को चीर कर इन जड़ों को उखाड़ लेगा, और वो भारी भरकम पेलन राक्षस इस जमीन को पापड़ बना डालेगा। Suddenly, there was a sound on the tree, a tuck, tuck, tuck sound. It surprised everybody. A man with a fierce-looking moustache was walking around the tree, knocking on the bark, measuring the trunk. Unni said, "Hamara waqt samapt hai. Hame ab koi baja nahi sakta." And he closed his eyes. Ali dropped down next to Unni, and he said, भगवान हमें बजा सकते हैं? Unni opened his eyes and said, भगवान? Ali said, मेरे अब्बू ना मदारी के बंदर थे, वो अपने उस्ताद के साथ टीन के छत वाले झोपड़ी में रहते थे। एक दिन ऐसे ही राक्षस उनकी झोपड़ी के छितड़े घर में आए। अब्बू के उस्ताद ने भगवान से प्रार्थना की, और फिर अब्बू ने कहा, वो राक्षस पता नहीं कैसे रुक गए, और उन सबकी झोपड़िया उस दिन बच गई। अली से मैं भी उस मंदिर में जाकर प्रार्थना करूंगा। चले भी इसे आज इंसान के भगवान को गिलरी इसको आज वो हम जानवरों की मदद क्यों करेगा? फतुल यू पैरेट आज वो बच्चों की मदद क्यों करेगा? अली से कोशिश में कोई हर्ज नहीं, when he jumped off the tree and leapt into the ground. Ali swung from tree to pole to tree until he could hear a rhythmic sound and some voices singing. अब्बू कहा करते थे कि ये इंसान अपने भगवान को गाना गाते हैं, और Ali started swinging faster and faster to the sound until he reached a temple where a priest was ringing a large bell. Tangam, tangam. Ali looked around. Suddenly, right there in the front row, his eyes shut tight, his palms clasped together, his lips moving, was the man with the fierce-looking moustache, Mr. Mujhwala. He was chanting, "Jai Bajrang Bali." Startled, he lost his grip and landed on his head. But he scurried into a corner, thinking to himself, "Mr. Mujhwala, he's the one who wants to be the one who will be the one who will be the one." And he turned to look at the idol and he froze. The god was a monkey. Bilkul mere jaisa. He waited for all the people to leave. And he went and stood before the monkey god. So ye hai unke Bajrang Bali.
He looks like me.
He has a tail like my tail. He's shaped like me. He has ears like me. So, Ali, puffed up his chest, stiffened his tail, stuck his bottom out and said, "Main Ali, hu Bajrang Bali." And he did it. In that instant, an idea flashed in his head. He turned to Monkey God, lowered his head, closed his eyes, clasped his palms together, moved his lips as he'd seen Mr. Mujhwala do, and he said, "Jai Bajrang Bali." Just then, a bell went tang. Bajrang Bali had spoken. Now, there were just two things Ali needed for his plan. And he knew just where to get them.
he stole into the grounds behind the Balgam Chowk, where the Ram Leela was being performed again this year. His eyes searched everywhere and he saw the actors. Ram, Lakshman, Sugriv, they all had what he wanted. But how would he get it from them? Then he saw him, a man with 10 heads, Ravan. Beside him was a mace, and the crown was slipping off one of his 10 heads. But he was fast asleep. The next day, in the office, Mr. Mochwala was giving last minute instructions. He said, a booming noise. Three engineers stood before him. And when he looked up, his moustache started pulling and he went, Basangali! The engineers looked at him and at each other, confused. Seeing the look on their faces, he pointed to the window. And he said, Dekho, dekho. Everyone turned.
There was nothing. Mochwala rushed out, looked everywhere, looked this way, looked that way.
Nothing.
He was shaking. What was that?
On his way home, Mr. Mochwala stopped by Balgam Chowk. Chukke said in an upside down voice, कहीं ये वो टक 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 वाला आदमी तो नहीं? चुपके से मुझे डर लग रहा है। चलिए भी कॉलिंग वर्सल कराओ तो ग्रांच से लगता है इसको किसी का डर नहीं। जस्ट देन मिस्टर मुचवाला सॉ द ब्रांचेस ऑफ द ट्री शेक विगरसली। Something sparkled between the leaves. Suddenly his eyes grew rounder and rounder. Mr. Mochwala fell to his knees, clasped his palms and lowered his head. Kilmeri, Dukke, Chukke, Jalebi looked up to see
Ali, a crowd in his head,
a mace in his hand, standing on the uppermost branch of the tree.
That night, Mr. Mochwala just could not sleep. He tossed and he turned.
Until he fell asleep at last, he had a
in which Lord Badrangbali appeared and said, Balga to go to Khabi Bhak, वही तो मैं तुम्हारी पूंछ को वैसे ही आग लगा दूंगा जैसे मैंने लंका में लगाया था।
इससे बदतर रोड प्लान मैंने जिंदगी में नहीं देखा। किस गधे ने सैंक्शन किया सर?
सर आपने
You are fired!
The next morning, Balgam Chowk, again it was morning.
And once again, only the night owl's eyes were wide open. And he was smiling. He said, Rakshas, ja rahe hai? Jalebi, Bindari and Sindaru, Dukke and Chukke, Farfariyu, Anguri, Chuppi and Chattapadar were watching. Ali could not stop laughing. He had saved the tree. Suddenly, someone came and yelled, Jai Badrangbali, and smashed the coconut. Everyone got a start. Mr. Mochwala clasped his palms together, closed his eyes and said, Mere Badrangbali, mujhe maaf kar do. Mujhe nahi maloom tha ye aapka ghar hai. Up in the tree where he was, Badrangbali, looking splendid, he raised his hand and blessed him. Mr. Mochwala tasted a big bunch of bananas. You know that Ali was very happy. When Mochwala was gone, Ali, now that the tree was safe, he would get his fill of bananas every day. He ate one. He ate two. He ate three. And he said, Jai Badrangbali. Unaware that someone somewhere was still missing his crown and mace.